do it again.
Silly question, really. All right. Okay, are you ready? Ready? Go. Off we go. Back he comes, and over. Good. There you are. Now, I'll take the rope back, and then we'll stop on the side of the pool here, and you can have a closer look at it. Away. Now let's start here. This is what he eats, mackerel, also herring and whiting. Prime quality stuff. All right, let's see that little face. There they are, open up. There they are. If you look carefully, you can see that the two sets of teeth interlock like that. Nothing gets out of there unless you want it to. There they are. Now, he gets through 30 to 40 pounds of this stuff every day. Quite a lot, really, about half of one of you in weight. It's prime quality, the same that you buy in the shop. The only difference is possibly, would you like to sit down so the people behind can see? Right. Here we are, let's have a look. Let's see that thing in the middle. Here we are. The only difference is with the fish is that we use obviously a lot more. And our fish has to be frozen before it's delivered here. Now this is to kill the bacteria, like Pseudomonas, the parasites, like tapeworms, the fish naturally that we don't want transmitted onto him. You of course do the same job by cooking or pickling your fish and taking the guts out. But he has his raw and whole. Would you like to look over there?
Yeah, why not?
Come on, your man, over here. Now, because we kill all the bacteria, and he has regular checkups, he's a lot healthier here than possibly he would be in the wild. Open up. There we are. Good lad. Now, in the wild, killer whales do not have any natural enemies. So this suggests but as nothing eats them, therefore nothing kills them that's bigger than them or nastier than them, but it is the disease and the parasites, like tapeworms, liver flukes, lung worms, it is that is the limiting factor on their stock size. Isn't that right? Eh? Now they are called killer whales, but this is a little misleading. There is no documented evidence to prove conclusively that a killer whale has ever eaten anybody, any person. I knew if you've been eaten by a killer whale, you're not around to tell the story. Hello. Go on, try again. A little further, this is a slide out, by the way. Good. Very nice. One more try. Just getting tail right out of the water. Come on. Really? Solid job. Good. Now that possibly is the only unnatural thing you'll see a killer whale do in captivity. Everything else, the playing and the jumping, he's quite capable of doing himself. But a healthy killer whale in the wild would probably not come out of the water intentionally. Now if you didn't want to do it, there's no way I could get him out of there, onto there. No way at all. He did it basically because I asked him to. And obviously I asked him to do it, but he wouldn't do it anyway unless he trusted me. Now, he knows that if he got stuck, I'd put him back. And a lot of training is to do with this bond you have between yourself and the animal. If you haven't got it, you won't be able to train anything. Not a dog, not a parrot, not a whale, not a dolphin. Now, I have a light beach ball here. I'm going to throw it in the water. And one in to give it a thump with his tail. Now it's a little light and there's a bit of a wind, so it may not work. But we'll give it a try. Under he goes and good. Not a bad start. If it does come your way, you'll find out why we use a very light beach ball. We don't want any fatalities in the audience. You missed. You missed. Try again. Good. Very nice. We'll finish that. I won't push my luck. Now these killer whales came from Iceland, as I said, but they are found globally. In fact, they're the most widely distributed mammal on Earth. Basically, wherever there's salt water, you find these guys. Mainly in the colder regions, but also even on the equator, where it's not hot. Isn't that right? Now I'll show you something they do in the wild. This is called spy hopping. He has his eyes, by the way, are here, just in front of that white patch. He can see underwater, he can see above water. Now he does this so he gets both eyes out of the water and he can have a good look around and see what's going on. That's right, isn't it? Up he comes. Have a little effort. There we are. Very good. Okay, now touch my hand and we'll leave it. Good. Very nice. Would you like to see another high jump before we finish? Yeah. How about you on the front row? You got off pretty lightly that time, so you didn't hit the ball. Maybe he will this time. Okay, let's see you up here. That's right. Ready, go! Off he goes around the pool. And up. We've got a few feet left. Never mind. There's another 2 toes left. Now a lot of people ask what they feel like. Well, they're very smooth and rubbery. The best description I've had, a little girl came on the stage and she said it felt like a peeled cardboard egg. And she's right, believe me. Next time you feel a hard morning, run your thumb over the surface under a tap. And that's what it feels like. Now everybody wave. Those over the age of 10 are excused. He's waving back. This ends the performing part of our show. Thank you all for coming. I hope you've enjoyed it. And good morning from us all. Now, if you'd like to see the rest of the animals within the ocean world,